What's up, future fighters? We are back. This is the video that we just recorded that is being uploaded for you. We will get back to those in a second. But first, we are in deep in the Shadow AI's main sequence loop here. And we just went over the think then act type structure that we have for this loop. And so we're back at the top here, and what we've done is we've gone into end combo, and we've gone into and we've kind of reset ourselves after being hit. And you can go back to the previous videos. I did a whole introductory series on this, so you can get step by step how it works, and including in-game demonstrations and of course the code behind it as well. So we get this non-strike move number 10 chosen, and then we execute this bad boy, and we know what this move is. It's down here, dodge, right here. You guys can see where my line is highlighted there. Dodge, combo, escape, neutral. So you go to dodge, and then the execution intent is block. You go into block, and you maintain your position. Super. That is exactly what you're supposed to do in that particular move, and he will execute that perfectly, and just like all combos will end up in end combo. And this move is different because you will not go into the normal should I extend my combo based on my transition type, should I go back to the main sequence loop. No, you go straight into combo escape sequence. And that is what we are working on today, which is very, very, very exciting. I've got it back there in the background here. Let's just close this for now because we're pretty much done with that. And then you're going to go here. And this combo escape sequence, what it is and what it does is after you get hit and you've retaking your center of gravity, you have moved with the force of the strike to decrease its harmful potential, and you're now ready to say okay. And you're blocking, so you're blocking and or dodging. Actually, you dodge first then block, so you're dodging and blocking any attacks that are currently coming in to eliminate any further damage. And now that you've reset, your eyes are back up, you're here, you're ready to go, what are you going to do? And Shadow AI has a system to decide on the answer to that question. And so, what is this based on? So first off, he checks the distance from opponent and whether he is outside the max striking range, whatever his max striking range is. And if for whatever reason, the opponent has hit me and has moved away while I was in block, he says, well, I don't need to attack back here. He's already moved away for me, so I can have time to rest. So I'm just going to go into a block move. And I'm going to check this max strike range here because it'll be set in this particular script. Let's see here. It'll be set in this particular script, max strike range. So of course all variables are initialized, not necessarily at zero, but they are initialized. At least that's the way I code. I like to initialize variables. I know some languages, you can just use them on the fly. You can create them in the fly, but I like having that library at the very top of a script to know what's in the bottom. So and where I'm starting. Well, always, and you always start from the same position, I like that. You always start from the same value. And so, let's see here. So next is a loop, and that loop looks like it's used to decide what the max range is going to be. Ah, and it is, actually. So you can see the Shadow AI is looping through C13 and 14, looping through all of these numbers, all these values here, to set the max distance. And so what it's doing is doing a comparison, right? It's doing a comparison and saying, is one greater than the other? And if it is, that's the new max distance. Now the question is, what do I do? Argument zero max distance. Let's see here. So, it does not equal max distance. So, okay, so the max strike range, this is pretty cool, takes those out, like, as far away as possible. C13 and 14, that would be down. That's weird. I keep... Well, anyway, that's zero. So, that's a weird thing. Let's see here. So if distance from is greater than zero, that wouldn't make any sense. So I think max distance, that must be kind of the width of the screen. That's probably what I did. Let's take a look. Let's go, wait, hold on a second. Let's go up to the top first. Yeah, width view. There it is. So I figured that's what I did. Let's just make sure I didn't change it anywhere. I don't think I would do that. Yeah. Okay, cool. I gone crazy there for a minute. All right, let's grab this variable again. Isn't coding fun? All right. Max strike range. So the max strike range ignores, it ignores that max distance. So it doesn't even take that into account when comparing it. And so it just says, you know, if it's looping through this, it says, okay, is this bigger than this? If yes, I'm the new max strike range. Is this bigger than this? If no, this stays. Is this bigger than this? No, it stays. Is this bigger than this? No, 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 no. No, and so it would say 415 is the max strike range, right? And so if I'm outside that range, in other words, I can't touch this guy. I just got hit. I'm reset. Maybe I want to, you know, maybe I want to just go ahead and pop him while I'm there. Well, if he's moved back 1,000 feet, well, okay, you know, let's regroup. And so he goes into a block. So that's how this first element of combo escape sequence works, and we're going to go through all the rest of these and show you the code and how it all works as well. Before we get to that though, go to docbrockgames.com and check out the alpha version of the game. You can check out the current features I have in the game, along with the two characters I have motion captured so far. Those motion captured moves in action, and yes, I did motion capture this. No, I did not stand on my head. We'll do motion capture later. It'll be fun. And then put your email address in at the bottom, and I'll let you know when the game comes out. Then back to you two, because we got more AI to make. I'll see you then.